Okay, good morning, everybody. Sorry about the technical difficulties this morning. So we have a short presentation for you on the product development side. This would have normally been done by our product developer, Christy Esposa, but he's busy working on some of the items today, so I'm gonna do it on his part. We just have a couple of items that we wanted to bring to your attention. And hopefully listeners would be making use of these items that we have and to continue. One of the first things that we have is for the compliance listings. A lot of persons have been stressed and trying to get back to the compliance ways and making use of the compliance tools that are available. So what we have now is we've added the European list. It was a list that was available prior, but hadn't been utilized by most clients. So we've actually, over the times, brought that list back up. So clients, if you need to add that additional list, it can be added to the EU list. And that can be added to the current listing that you have, if you have the OFAC, if you have the World Check, and so forth. So that could also be included. We also have added the additional option for clients who probably want to update the internal listing. We know that over time, a lot of persons have been going through and they want to make changes to the list and so forth, and you don't want to manually enter each one by one to do it in that way. So we've also added the option to update, mass update that internal listing. So what it will do is once you do the update, it's going to clear off everything that was in there before, and then you'll have a brand new list that you can utilize in terms of your internal list, internal watch list that you would want to use that for your clients. So we have these options that are available in terms of the compliance listings. And if anybody out there has any additional list that they would like to include into Alchemy as part of the screening, then they could also contact us and let us know, so then we could discuss and see the possibilities of also adding these lists into the Alchemy application as well. Over time as well, we've also made some amendments to the ACH interface. And though we have the ACH in different jurisdictions, we have it in, you have Belize, you have the OECS Islands, you have it in Jamaica. We've made some modifications based on the whole ACH interface processing. So one of the things that we've now done is to be able to first to track the movement of the file. So what we've done is we've been able to now, when a file is placed in a specific location on the system, the Alchemy PPS is going to consume that file, and then we're going to, if it's processed, it's going to go to a process folder. If it has an error, it's going to go to an error folder. So we've made it much easier for users to be able to look and see at any point in time where that ACH file is, what has happened to that file. And then if you need to make corrections or you need to make alterations, that has been made much easier for you to be able to do that. We've also tried to automate as much as possible in terms of the placement of the files and the picking up of the files. So we have kind of automated the process that if the file is placed in a specific location, Alchemy is going to consume it and process and do whatever it needs to do. Just the same as if we need to send it to a specific location, whether it be on the Montran system or on a specific computer that hosts that application, that is also available where we could send that file to that specific location. We've also done some correction on the various outputs of the ACH. We have ACH, ACH credits, so we've made alterations based on the options that have been chosen by the various clients. These have also been set up and configured. And also for the ACH returns, we've made some amendments to be able to properly process the payments, the returns, to handle the payments based on the configurations that should be in place. So these are some of the things that we've actually adjusted so far. In addition, we've also done some work for the batch processing, and that, for persons who don't know, it's the corporate batch. And this is used if you don't want to, you could have the customers send all the payments that they need to process in a file, Alchemy will create payments out of these transactions that are included in the file and then process them. So we've also made some changes to that in terms of automating the process where the file can be placed in a location and be processed automatically. And we've also made the alterations to be able to track and see how all of these are all these payments are being processed. We've also made adaptions for if a GL account is going to be used and certain wash accounts. So we've really made some changes and some validation on the fields that are being used in terms of the batch processing aspect. The last, one of the last things that we had was the e-alerts. And it was what we've done for this e-alert notification. And these are notifications that can be done if you have that module, you will be able to, if once a debit or a credit or any action occurs on the customer's account, they will receive an email notification. So in this case, what we've done is we've modified one of the alerts, which is the Swift alert, and we could actually send an actual copy of the Swift message in the email to the client. So they will get an actual copy of the Swift message and based on the Swift format that is being used. So that could also be submitted to the client for action. So if they need to have a copy of the actual message, that could be included as part of that e-alert. So it's a special e-alert. This won't be treated as an RFC, but it's a special alert that can be defined so the customers will actually get a copy of the Swift message that is being sent. So they can see what has been sent and they can have that as evidence in terms of processing. So I also want to include, Morales spoke about the new, we spoke earlier about the things that have happened during COVID and new developments and new aspects and new things that are being thought of. One of the new things that we've had is something that I think most of the clients, most if not all clients have been asking for in terms of trying to preview their reports and stuff before they actually goes to the printer. So what we've been doing, we've been working with to get that done. And we have a new product that we think will be able to do what the clients want. So instead of the receipts actually going to the printer, they could be previewed prior. So you could have an option to see what it is that will be in that receipt before actually sending it to the printer. You would also have the option to distribute, for example, there's certain reports that can be distributed via email. They could go to certain persons within the organization. You also have the option that these reports could be converted into to PDF or HTML. So it is very different from the what we have now, where you just click, you print, and then you don't know the outcome, not until it goes to the printer and you see it's maybe it's not what you want. So this is something new that we've been working on. And anybody who needs any information on this product could send an email to the customer support. You could reach out to any one of your contacts at IBIS Management, and then we could provide some more information on this product and how it works. I think we would also be able to do a short demo on that, and then so you could see how it works and then see if it suits the needs of your bank. Another aspect that we are actually working on or looking to integrate is second factor authentication. I think we mentioned earlier about security and the fact that now we in COVID times and everything needs to be more secure. One of the things that we're working on also is to have a second factor authentication when users access the Alchemy environment. So what this would look at is basically the user would put their username and password, and then prior to them accessing the menus and getting onto Alchemy itself, they will be prompted for some form of second factor authentication. So this would work with your current IBM i system, and you would have the option to use your your authentication item, whether it be Google Authenticator. Normally everybody knows IBIS and we use Entrust as second factor authenticator. You could use Entrust. So whatever second factor authentication system that you have, we would try to integrate that, and then you would have, once a user is logged into Alchemy, they put their username, their password, then they will be prompted to put a second form of authentication before they actually get onto the system. So this is more in terms of safeguarding that users don't just, you don't just have, if they, somebody knows your username and password, they could get on, they would need to have that second piece that that employee would need to have close to them at all times. So this is another one that we're working on, and that is available in terms of second factor login. So once the user gets into Alchemy, puts the username, password, then they'll be prompted for a second form of authentication. So this is what we wanted to present for now. That's what I have want to present. But we also have one other item, which is a concept that we that one of our new system developers has been working on, and that is making use of WhatsApp in terms of payment processing. And I'm going to pass it on to Jendrik, who's going to present that concept to you, and you're going to see a short demonstration, a small video in terms of how that aspect actually works as well.